Hello, today we're gonna make a nice clay morphic pop-up illustration. If you want to learn these, I also covered them extensively in my second course, The High Fidelity in Mobile Apps. You can get it in the link from the description below. We already defined what clay morphism is, so now let's make something in that style. I'm gonna start with an empty artboard in Figma filled with a gradient coming from a light blue towards white, and now let's make a rectangle in the middle of it. I'm gonna make the rectangle horizontal like this, but you can go with a vertical card as well. Now let's round the corners, and I'm gonna go with 100 because the idea is to be above 50%, and as you can see, 200 gives us a fully rounded pill shape. So something between 0 and 200, which is 100. And you can also try something a little bit higher, so like 120. There are a couple of ways to bend that shape. You can either place a point and bend this, or simply hold the Control on Windows or Command on the Mac key and drag the edge outwards. This works only in Figma, and I believe Sketch actually does it better because you can simply place a point and drag it and the proper roundness gets created automatically. Most of the effect comes from the rounding of the top and the bottom edge, but you can also round the sides the same way. You should end up with something looking similar to this. The other option is, and for that I'm gonna duplicate this entire artboard and create the rectangle all over again, and of course add the roundness all over again. The other option is to press Enter to enter the editing mode and then simply add a point onto the middle of the top edge. And now you can try to drag that point using the handles and modify the curvature or the bend of the edge that way. It takes a little getting used to, and it really works better in Sketch than in Figma. Once you have the shape that you like, remove the other one and let's start playing around with it. The first thing that we want to do is to change the default fill color of that shape to white, because gray is really not gonna work in this style. So I'm just gonna drag the slider here and pick it white. Now let's go into effects and add an inner shadow. We want it to be consistent with the background, so for the color I'm gonna pick the blue, and the blue is not gonna be like from the very top of the gradient. Now for the X and Y value, go with negative 24 and then double with the blur value. And as you can see, you already have the effect because some of that shadow actually spills on the top and the left side as well. This effect can be achieved with just one inner shadow, but let's add the second one. For this, we want a lighter inner shadow, and I'm gonna make it 2 times smaller. So it's gonna be 12 on the X and Y axis and 24 blur. And for that, I'm gonna pick the lighter shade of the already established shadow that we have. And as you can see, it actually creates this effect a little bit more visible, but it works either way. Now it's time to add a drop shadow to it. First of all, it needs to be blue, so I'm gonna pick the color of the background. And for now, we want that drop shadow to go into the direction where the larger inner shadow is, so basically bottom right. And we want that shadow to be a little bit darker. I made it the same size as the inner shadow, which is 24, 24, and 48 in blur. Then you need to adjust the brightness and the saturation of the shadow color, but just make sure that the edge where the inner shadow meets the outer shadow is not blurry. So it has to be visible, it has to stand out, kind of like this. We're going to make this into a very simple Hello Clay Morphism card with one button. I'm gonna create a rectangle for that, and of course we need to round the corners. That's the first thing that we do. And we don't want a pill-shaped button, so something around 40 for this size is gonna be okay. Now, having the object selected, press Enter and go into the point editing mode and simply drag those edges like this. So we want this button to have a similar shape. That's one option. It doesn't have to, because if the card has that shape, it sometimes is completely enough. Now let's pick the blue that we have, but we want it a little bit darker and more visible. So pick the color and simply move the hue to be a little bit more saturated. Of course, this button is too flat, so we're gonna add an inner shadow to it to create that fluffy 3D effect. Now, because the object is smaller than the card, the shadow itself has to be smaller too. So I'm gonna go with negative 12, negative 12, and 24 for the blur. And then for the color, I'm gonna pick the exact same blue that we have and then simply add a little bit more saturation to it and decrease brightness just a tiny bit. This is one of the better ways to actually create nice looking buttons like that. So don't go with a black shadow that has some opacity, but instead opt for simply a more saturated or darker version of that same color. And I'm gonna do the same thing with the additional shadow on the other edge. Simply modify the color a little bit. And for that shadow, I'm gonna go with half the values, so it's gonna be 6, 6, and 12. Now, let's quickly add some text to this. So I'm just gonna write hello claymorphism, add a nice emoji to it, and on the bottom, I'm just gonna write a response, which is hi exclamation mark. This is just a very simple example. It's not a real UI, of course. Now let's add a drop shadow to the button itself. And for that drop shadow, first of all, I'm gonna pick the darker shade of blue from the inner shadow here, and I'm gonna increase the blur. So it's gonna be like 24, but this time I'm not gonna add anything to the X value. So the button is gonna look simply a lot nicer if it just has a little bit on the Y value. Then increase the opacity until the edge still looks good and is not blurry, something like this. And if you believe that this little inflated look is a little bit too much for all the elements, you can remove it from the button. So you can simply move the edges to be straight again. And I'm gonna opt for this one because the card itself, the window itself, is actually pretty over the top already, so the button can be pretty standard. It already has the inner shadow that gives it depth. Now you can find some nice 3D icons to complement it. These ones are from Icons 8. I got them as transparent PNGs, so I'm gonna simply rotate them around a little bit. For this one, I'm gonna flip it horizontally and place it on the right side of our card. That's because on the other side, on the left, we want the other icon, the pointing finger, that's kind of touching or pressing the button. So I'm gonna place it in a way where the finger is almost in the middle of the button vertically and a little bit to the left for more optical weight distribution. To make it look a little bit more natural, I'm gonna create a custom shadow for this object. So I'm gonna create an oval, pick a color from one of the darker parts of the object itself, move it under the graphics on the layer list, and then simply apply some blur to it. And of course, we need to also decrease the opacity and play around with the positioning of this a little bit. Now let's duplicate it and move it under the second hand, and also just make sure that it's in a place where it looks natural for the object. So if most of the objects are casting the shadow to the right and towards the bottom, then these shadows should be in a similar direction. Same with light. If those hands have that lit element from the left side, then it's good to actually keep it consistent with the card. Now, because this is an exploratory illustration and not a real interface, we can actually go a little bit further here. I'm gonna create a little oval and then paste it under the graphic. That kind of looks like the finger is touching the oval. Now I'm gonna pick the darker shade of blue for the oval color and then apply layer blur to it. That will give us the impression, if the blur is big enough, that this button is like an inflated balloon and the finger is kind of pushing it in a little bit. Now the last part for consistency is that I'm gonna select all the black text, pick a blue color for it, and then decrease the saturation and the brightness until we end up with a dark gray with a hint of blue in it. That's gonna make it a lot more consistent with the rest of the illustration. Now I'm gonna use some squares to optically align the text on the button to be exactly in the middle, and because this is an illustration, not something to be coded, I'm gonna actually add a diagonal point here. So it's 436.5, and that way the text is exactly in the middle. The last thing we can do here is to duplicate our little indentation that we created for the button, and then simply move it under the other finger that's holding the entire card, and then of course desaturate it to match the color of the shadow that's there. So I'm just gonna use the color picker to pick the color of the inner shadow, and then slightly tweak the saturation and the brightness. And we're done here. Now you know how to create the claymorphic effect. Of course, this is a little bit over the top as an illustration, so you can just dial it back a tiny bit if you're gonna work on a real interface, but buttons like these are actually proven to be quite effective. Have a great day. Cheers.